Yo, what's good? It's your boy Chubb Nasty, Lieutenant Chubb, and I'm here with Tone Tone Pepperone. It's early in the morning, way too fucking early for me to be up, so this is gonna be a good one.
We're doing that, early day booking today.
That early day booking. So
We pulled
we
engaged
had
Spicoli. We're here, 8 hours before the show.
Yeah, and you know what? We gotta be honest, we fucked up. We were supposed to have this big event, the Christmas on a Pole pay-per-view. But the audio didn't record. So
Let's just say some people might have been faded. Some people might have forgot to put the audio on. We're not pointing any fingers at
I really
anyone.
hope you fucking put it on this time.
But
I'm fucking
the
pointing fingers.
audio is on this time.
Tone Pepperone ruined Christmas. Let's just say that.
I may have sabotaged Christmas on a pole.
Fuck.
But we're back this time and we're gonna
cringe.
recoup. We're not going down like WCW.
No. So, we'll give you a little rundown of what happened, and then we're gonna head for the what is it, the Iron Man Donkey Punch?
Yep, Iron Man
Yeah.
Donkey Punch.
GGE Iron Man Donkey Punch. Okay, so all of our matches for the Christmas on a Pole were two-toned, Christmas-themed and on a pole. So we had the first one, Low-Ki, Wife Beater, and Amazing Red in a triple threat Christmas tree on a pole match. Now, the best way to describe that is there is a pole, and on top of that pole is another pole. And on top of that pole is a Christmas tree, and the objective is to be the first one to put the star on top of the Christmas tree. Low-Ki was a cheating fuck, and he won.
We like to have our heels cheat because if you're getting a decisive win, that ends a storyline. Once, the face or the heel gets a decisive win, the storyline's over. How do you come back? It's something, I've heard a lot of wrestling bookers in real life say. How do you come back from a story when you have a clean finish? Like, there can't be a second part if there was a clean finish. You already cleanly lost.
Exactly.
Like, you were beat. You were not the better guy. I mean, maybe you can come back the second time and cheat and win, but I've always thought it was better to have, the cheating, and then it builds up to that decisive win, because then it's like, finally, I wanted that.
Yeah. So for our second match, we did Damian Sandow and CM Punk in just a one-on-one Santa Claus on a pole match. And I would think that would be pretty self-explanatory. The first one to climb up the pole and sit on Santa's lap.
I'd like to point out that this is December 2001, so we realized the potential and star power of Damian Sandow 10 years earlier than WWE.
He's got that star power now. We're bringing it out 13 years in the past.
We're not sticking him on the apron to be the sidekick to Miz.
No.
He's the main attraction here.
All right. So, our next
Shout out to my
thing.
Steam friends who keep popping up in the corner.
Yeah, shout out to Tony's Steam friends. Anyways, our next thing. We were going to make it a match, but it's actually an angle. Christmas dinner on a pole match. So Billy Kay, a.k.a. Now Yetzel Goldstein, he comes out and Kendrick in London and the Clown Car Posse, a.k.a. Burrito Supreme and Pogo the Clown, they're getting ready for their wrestling match. And he comes in the back room and he's just like, yeah, you guys aren't going to be wrestling tonight. And they're like, what the fuck? And he's like, yeah, you guys are going to be sitting on poles in the middle of the ring, and the first team to finish their Christmas dinner wins.
I mean, to be fair, Pogo wasn't too sad about this. I mean, he likes to eat.
Yeah, Burrito looked pretty happy. London, he kind of threw a bitch fit, and he's like, but I have to watch my
Yeah,
carbs.
London and Kendrick, they're They're trying to eat healthy. Burrito, Pogo, on the other hand, they dominated this angle.
It was an absolute just train wreck over Kendrick in London. What up, Dip?
It was the eating equivalent to a little kid fighting a pro MMA fighter.
Mm-hmm.
It was a landslide.
It was. And it actually went over pretty well. E-minus for a rating. So,
Burrito not too Supreme, bad. Better than... Burrito Supreme's eating like Joey Chestnut.
Fuck. They're just scarfing it down like Kobayashi.
This isn't the Nathan's contest?
Oh. Oh. And finally, we have Blitzkrieg and Super Dragon in a 1v1 Hell in a Cell wrapped in Christmas lights on a pole match for the Trap House World Championship. Now, this was by far our most dangerous map because not only could this Hell in a Cell fall off the poles if you hit it the wrong way, it's wrapped in electrical wiring, so if you throw some water or shit on it, these people might die. So Blitzkrieg beat Super Dragon, and this is going to be Blitzkrieg's heel turn, because he just, post-match, he beats the shit out of Super Dragon.
Yeah, he does, he did go heel turn. It didn't go over as well as we thought it would. I mean, we built it up for a while. It wasn't like, you know, we just did it. We built it up for, you know, 6 to 8 segments. I don't remember exactly which one. But it was somewhere in that area. And we had built it up, and, you know, we did a lot of angles. We did a lot of him hinting during matches. I thought it would go over better. It didn't go over as well as I had hoped. But from here on, we're going to separate the Super Dragon Blitzkrieg storyline and really, you know, start pushing both of them big. So when eventually we turn Super Dragon face, which we will, and they clash again in a few months for the title, it'll be built back up. We're not just going to do it again. We're going to try to build it back up.
Yeah, what he said.
Yeah, what he said.
I'm sorry, it's early in the morning. All right.
Let's get to booking the next one. We're 21 days away. We made 4,000. We're going to have to sim a few days, but
yeah,
screw it.
And CM Punk is still being a little bitch.
CM Punk's just pro complainer.
Dude, what a fucking
Did you see Off the Record with Michael Lanza?
No, I didn't.
He did another interview within, I think it was in the last few days. And you know, that dude Michael Lanza, Off the Record, he's always kind of a little bit of a snarky smartass.
Okay, yeah.
So CM Punk called him on it on camera, and he was like, you know, I find it's funny how when the camera's off, you're over here trying to be my friend, and then when the camera's on, you know, you're trying to get up in my shit. Like, he goes, I like your gimmick. He goes, it doesn't make me mad at all. He's like, I like it. He's like, it's a good gimmick, kid. He's like, I don't know what you mean. What do you mean? He's like, you know what I mean. He's like, don't play games.
Don't you fucking play games.
Don't sit here and play stupid on camera. Oh, yeah, that's right. Another thing. Picked up Ahmed Johnson last time. And Rick Martel. Rick. Fucking Milo Martel.
Rick Martel. I know Tony's like, a big...
Yeah, I was going to say, if you don't like Rick Martel, like, fuck you.
Yeah, Tony's got a big old hard-on for Rick Martel, and I saw him there. I'm like, okay, you know, Rick Martel, he's pretty fucking sick, so.
Dude, Rick Martel had an awesome feud in WCW in 98 with Booker T. Booker T at the time was, you know, he was not a main guy. He was underappreciated. He had an awesome set of matches, spent over a few months. It was great. Big fan of Rick Martel. Who else did we pick up? Oh, we picked up Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Yep.
Why is he signed to Road Agent? What?
Well, that's just not who he is.
Yeah, right? Like, who the fuck
is that? We get
and
it.
And they put Russo back to Authority?
Russo.
No, he's still a road agent, all right.
Russo. chill, Russo.
I don't know why the hell they put him as a road agent. That was so weird.
Yeah, that's pretty weird.
Let's put Greg Valentine off the auto push list. Apparently it's acting fucking weird. CM Punk's still a enhancement talent?
He's still all pissed off for his signed push.
Dude, do you remember back in the day when him and John Morrison were feuding and John Morrison said to him, what does CM Punk stand for? Chasing men? Oh no, he's a lower mid-carder now. Good for you. You moved up in the world. With the, what's up with that Becky from Roseanne haircut, though? Jesus.
Yeah, he is Becky from Roseanne. Fucking Roseanne. What a show.
The show was fucked.
It was fucked.
It was a funny-ass show. It just was fucked. Jesus.
Yeah.
I'm interested to see how much we're going to push the storylines with the new picks we got. I think we should be able to get to small size with the people we got because we're paying a little bit more money.
No. Well, we have the money to
dish
out now.
I mean, even if we lose money for a few months, we got $37,000, so we're not going to lose crazy money.
Exactly.
Saban, what is your problem? You're going to start pulling a CM Punk now?
Oh, my God.
I don't want to be in a Saban. Listen, everyone's got a job for a while, Saban. Get over it.
Exactly.
You think fucking Mick Foley can play? No, he went over to Japan and lost half his ear in a barbed wire match. No, it wasn't a barbed wire match. Was it a barbed wire match? It was against Abdullah the Butcher, I know that, and his head got caught in the ropes. And his fucking ear came off. But I think it was during a barbed wire match.
Yeah, I think. I don't know. Mick Foley is a crazy motherfucker.
Yeah, dude, it's hard to remember. Mick Foley's been a lot of crazy fucking shit. Who was it? I think it was, Jerry Lawler who used to call him a human crash test dummy?
Yes.
Dude from
probably the most accurate description I've ever heard for him, so.
Yeah, dude, if he didn't jump off that Hell in a Cell, he probably would have had a much longer career.
Oh, no doubt.
Like, I've heard him say in a lot of interviews that, that really shortened his career.
I could imagine.
He's had a limp ever since. If you go back and watch the old videos, like, he walked normal until that match.
Yeah.
He had a brutal last man standing match with The Rock, too. Rock hit him in the fucking head with a chair like 25 times.
Fuck. Mick Foley can take a fucking beating.
Yeah, right? How do you kick that guy's ass at a bar if you've ever gotten a shit with him? Just punch the shit out of him and he's like, is that all you got? Like, what?
Yeah, like, he's that guy that you punch in the face and he's like, have to do a lot better than
so
that.
So then you pick up a fucking pool stick. Yeah, man, you wonder why no one's fucking looking at the game. All right, this storyline, it's over. It's done. This storyline still has room to go. Because it's up to me. I think we can do better.
Yeah. No, people are starting to like this storyline.
Did we make them an official team? Yes, who, right. Yeah, the clowning around.
Yeah.
Clown car posse.
Yeah, no, they've been an official team for a little while now.
Man, it's hard to remember some of this shit, man. I've played this game so much that, like, just the shit intersects. Okay. Let me take a look at our main eventers. I'm not even looking at top or mid cards right now. All right, Blitzkrieg needs to be hopped up. He's only an E+.
Yeah.
Oh, I know who he's going to beat this week, this month. Paul London. I don't know why Paul London has E+ momentum.
Yeah, why the fuck does Paul London have E plus momentum?
Like, it's, you know what though? Do I want to be Paul London? Because I, Pogo and Burrito are gonna take their momentum soon, probably.
That's true.
Yeah, probably tonight actually. Probably have them two fight. So, damn, who can we have Blitzkrieg? Because he's a heel now. We have no main event faces.
No main event
faces. We have not one main event face.
Okay.
Or upper mid card, for that matter. So we're going to have to... Okay. I know how we could save this, actually.
All right, well, Pogo's going to start heading to our main event face.
Is someone not here? No, everyone's here. Oh, it's because Ahmed's considered an occasional wrestler. Okay. We'll do Ahmed Johnson versus... Super Dragon. Super Dragon's going to beat him.
Okay.
Actually, you know, or should we have... Blitzkrieg's the champ. Let Blitzkrieg do it. It makes sense. Because we want him to get pushed. Ahmed Johnson has... you know, notoriety already from WWE. So basically, you know, it's going to show that our guy is legit. He's beating one of these old WWE guys.
Okay, okay.
I'm trying to get some good thinking going, but I'm a little tired.
Yeah, it's hard in the morning.
I haven't had enough coffee yet.
I haven't had any coffee yet. I pretty much got out of bed, turned on my computer, and here I am.
It's going to be tainted. Flash.
Yep.
I'm not going to put the title on. You know what? We are going to put the title on the line. Ahmed. Listen, you can do the job, or you can just get screwed like Bret Hart.
No. Okay, you know what? Keep him strong then.
I'm going to try both, and if he still has a problem... He's not getting... Okay, you know what? You're not getting either now. I'm going to have him dominate you. Like, that's what you get for being a moody fucking prick, Ahmed.
You want to be a little bitch, this is what
now
happens.
I don't care. That's what you get, Ahmed.
Yeah. You're going down like the clown now.
You're lucky I don't have fucking Shaggy 2 Dope hired and beat the shit out of you. Like, because that's the next insult. And then the insult after that, you get ran over by Pogo.
Violent J's going to join up in the company and just kick the shit out of you.
Okay. He's quite upset over that. I'm furious. Shut up.
I'm so mad. No, you don't get to be mad. You fucking signed up for this.
It's your fucking job. Stop complaining. Just a fucking locker room of Hulk Hogan's. Creep control. Alright, let's have the Hammer go against... I want to save Sandow for another match. I want him to win.
Mm-hmm.
Let's have him go up against... We could have Super Dragon win this one.
Could do that. Could do that.
Throw Loki in here. We need a face, actually. Damn, dude, we got no fucking faces.
We're an evil company.
We really need to build up AJ.
Yeah.
So actually, we're going to have AJ in this. They're both going to lose, but since they're fighting Greg, who's a main eventer, it's gonna push them up.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll have AJ kept strong in this match. Tainted one. the forward. What else can we do here? We got to do... Let's do a regular 2v2 ladder match.
Okay. You know,
let's make that a TLC.
Yeah. Is this the Pogo and...
Yep.
Yeah, perfect.
The Clown Car Posse. And we're going to have Pogo win this one.
Of course we're going to have Pogo win it.
Retrieval. Decisive win.
Yeah.
We're going to end this for a little bit after this. We're just them fighting these two.
Mm-hmm.
Because these two need to be built up a little bit after this.
Yeah, what is it? Like Brian Kendrick's got like a D or mm-hmm. something for momentum?
We're going to get the momentum on them. Have them win. Build them up again. And then once they're built up again, we'll have them start beating them again.
I like it.
Because every time they run into the Clown Car Posse, no matter how good they are, they just get their ass whooped. Because it's the fucking Clown Car Posse.
It is the fucking Clown Car Posse.
Let's do another singles match. You know, let's do a multi-man match.
Ooh.
Let's do 3v3 elimination. What do you think?
Okay.
We'll have Super Dragon, because this is going to be the winning team right here.
Mm-hmm.
Super Dragon, Damian Sandow, and CM Punk.
Okay, I can live with that.
They're going to be Frankie Kazarian, Chris Sabin, because he's enhancement talent.
Yeah.
I'm going to leave Wifebeater alone.
Yeah.
Put an Amazing Red, because he's got decent momentum. Oh, he's a face. You know what, CM Punk? You're going over here because you're a crybaby. Yeah. Okay, that looks good. Then we think, have Super Dragon win? Or Damien?
Our boy Damien.
You know Mike's a Damien Sandow fan. He's going to win over Super Dragon.
Mm-hmm. No, if it's between Sandow and Super Dragon, I'm sorry, Super. I got to go with the stunt double himself.
We going decisive or tainted?
Let's give him a decisive win. He kills it.
Let's go, Mizd out. The motherfucker's so funny. It's probably the best thing in WWE's product right now.
Absolutely.
I will say, though, watching him get German suplex by Brock Lesnar, the triple suplex the other night, it brought back shit. It reminded me of Benoit the minute I seen that, because he used to do that.
Right.
I was like, so that's how it is? It's you kill him off in the universe, and then it's like, oh, we'll just use all of his moves, but not mention him. Who was it that was using the crossface not too long ago? Was it Triple H? I think it was Triple H in one of his matches. He was using like the crippler crossface. I'm like, what the fuck?
I think so, yeah.
It's not just him. There was a few people that have done it. And then Daniel Bryan's hold is awfully similar.
It's like completely similar.
Yeah.
Who else has it? John Cena.
Cena, yeah.
Yeah.
No, that's TFT of you. You don't know what you're talking about.
No, it's TFT of you.
Shut up. It's not. It's the same fucking move.
It's the crippler crossface. You are using the move of a man who killed his family.
Like, they literally were just like, instead of going here, I'll move back 3 inches and it's a completely different move. No, it's not. Not at all.
No, but yo, the positioning.
The positioning. It's all in the way you present it. We're going to have Cole Cabana win this one. Because, I mean, wife beater, he's wife beater.
Wife beater is wife beater.
Wife beater will be all right. Yeah. Actually, you know what? Maybe that should be a little... No, 10 minutes, all right. Segments are all over the place. That looks right, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
We need a segment.
You need a segment, eh? Okay.
We're supposed to be at 80%. We're at 100%. Sorry about that.
That's cool. Okay, you said you wanted to end the Clown Car Posse and Hooligans feud for now. Why don't we do an angle about that? Like,
they shake hands in the ring afterwards?
No, fuck that.
Like, are we going the good way out because they're good guys, or are we still just because it's Pogo, he's going to beat the shit out of him but still be a good guy? Like, is Pogo, like, got that Steve Austin effect where he's a bad guy but he's still good?
Yes.
But he's goofy at the same time?
Yeah, we're gonna do that because basically the way I'm thinking it, the feud, Pogo and Burrito wanted it to end so long ago, but Kendrick and London are like, "Nah, we fucking got you this time, bruh. We got you. We're gonna fucking get you," and just.
I got it. Maybe you want to type this one up. Tell me what you think. It's the end of the match, right? They're still feuding.
Okay.
Pogo goes out to the ring. He goes under the ring. Everyone's like, oh, shit. You know, he's going to grab a chair. He's going to grab a table. You know, what the fuck is this going to be? He grabs one of those fucking huge Rock'em Sock'em, like, boxing gloves. Just the ridiculously sized boxing gloves.
Okay.
Comes into the ring and flat out knocks out Paul London.
I love it.
Flat out knocks out Paul London with a Rock'em Sock'em fucking boxing glove.
That's beautiful.
Everyone's like, yo, you just got knocked out with that big ass glove on. Like, wow. That thing's got 4 feet of padding.
That's pretty cool with me.
So then the commentators start selling it like, damn, how strong is this dude that he needs a glove that big and he still knocked him out?
Like, I'm loving it. He crushes this dude.
Yeah, it's like when Pogo goes full force, like, watch out. Don't make Pogo serious.
No, you don't want to fuck with Pogo. Pogo's not someone to be fucked with.
Oh, hold on, wait. After he knocks out Paul London, he puts a red clown nose on Paul London.
And throws a pie in his face.
Yes.
Yeah. Alright, okay, give me a sec. I'm going to type this out.
I think this might have just turned out to the best show yet. I could see that in my head, and that would be hilarious. Gets knocked out with a fucking huge glove, gets a nose put on him, and then a fucking pie smashed in his face. You know some funny shit? You remember when DX impersonated the McMahons?
Yeah.
And fucking Triple H yelled in his face, "Shut up!" He fell down. Shit was funny. That was one of the funnier DX segments. Dude, did you know that Rick Martel was retired when we picked him up?
I didn't know that, actually.
They got him as a personality.
Huh.
We should probably not have him working here for 740 Not Wrestling.
Yeah, I mean...
We were going to have to do that after the show.
All right, okay, so I typed a little something-something up for you.
Let's see this. After the match, Pogo the Clown crawls underneath the ring. He comes back out from under the ring wearing a big-ass Rock'em Sock'em boxing glove. Hops into the ring and knocks the fuck out of Paul London. Pogo then puts a red clown nose on Paul London and then hits him in the face with a pie. Love it. Write this shit. Okay. Call it KO by Big Ass Glove. This is a skit. No, it's an action. Risk low. It's got to be at least a minute, and it can go on for 10.
Sounds good.
God damn it. I hate having to do this. Just fucking horrible. Worker 1, Worker 2, both rated on... Worker 1 is definitely going to be on entertainment.
Oh, of course.
What should 2 be on? Should be entertainment or acting? Probably entertainment, right?
Yeah, I'd say so.
I mean, it is sports entertainment. Confrontation. Hype.
Alright.
Paul London. You like how I made it so Paul London is the one who got knocked out, right?
Of course.
I like the wording, knocks the fuck out of Paul London.
Right? I thought you would. I'm a fucking wordsmith.
Paul London just gets laced. Fault angle, yes, I'm saving this motherfucker.
Well, of course.
Make this 10 minutes.
I don't know if we can do 10 minutes. Yeah, we can't do 10 minutes too much. 5 minutes.
Well, yeah. I don't know. 6 minutes.
Okay, 6 minutes. Yeah, we can live with that. Okay. Wait a sec. Pop it up right after the match. There we go. All right. Fucking book the match. F+. Okay.
Cole Cabana got a C+.
No worker improvements. Hey, wife beater's kind of sewering us, so might have to reconsider his standing.
It's got an E. Not bad.
Okay, not bad at all. Pogo. Right on. That's what I like
Good
to
job,
see.
Pogo.
E-. Nice.
That's what's up.
Beautiful.
It's nice when the homemade shit comes in good.
Right. Okay, this is nice.
Extremely poor match. They got an E, though. I mean,
yeah.
Great Valentine got a B rating, man.
Yeah. Process, any worker improvements? No. Okay, that's fine.
I would have sworn that these two would have learned something from fucking the hammer.
E plus, okay.
That's what's up, man. Fucking Blitz puts on a good show, man.
He does.
I like how Ahmed Johnson improved.
He's getting way better.
Right? Like, he fought Blitzkrieg, and he was like, damn, son.
And E minus. Okay. Not bad.
No improvements. But you know what? Pulling the minus out of, you know, dudes we were getting Fs with, that's good.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck you with the storylines already. Let's tell Pogo that he's doing good, man.
Oh, Pogo was
killing it. Pogo's killing it every show.
Yeah. Let's tell Ahmed he did well.
Pointed out as a good example.
Yeah. And Damian Sandow, love it.
Yeah, definitely. We'll tell him. We'll compliment him on a good performance.
Of course.
Make speech. Maybe Ahmed won't be so pissed at us now.
Maybe he won't be a little bitch.
Maybe he'll just be irritated.
Okay, hold on. I want to read the...
All right.
GDE Iron Man Donkey Punch, number 4.
Was not that bad given the company is so small. That's not necessarily a thumbs up. It's not a thumbs down, though. We gotta pull some more people.
Oh, Ahmed has big morale issues.
We only made $2,000 last month. It's not good.
No, it's not good.
First things first, Rick Martel. Sorry, buddy. I mean, you're not a wrestler.
Yep.
Angry. You know what, Ahmed? I think you're gonna lose the next pay-per-view. I think Ahmed's going to lose until he has no momentum and he gets fired.
I like it.
Because, you know, when you're a bitch in this company, that's what happens.
Exactly. We hire you solely to lose.
Like we have the people we're pushing. This is WCW. We're just pushing the people we like.
Exactly.
Our homies. Dude, by the way, I think soon, I mean, I don't want to say it officially, it's not official, but I think I'm going to do a homemade mod.
Ooh.
Just for, like, everyone we play with online.
I like that.
Well, it's still going to be in the same, like, in the real universe, like, with the real world mods like this, but we're going to have our own company with us starting in it. As, like, no talent wrestlers and actually building ourselves up with the company.
I like that.
I think I'm going to do with the hardcore company.
It's a pretty good idea, actually.
It's not a bad idea to get us over because, I mean, hardcore wrestling is the easiest to do. I mean, it's the most brutal on the body, but performance-wise, you ain't going to do shit.
Yeah. It's, like, it's the only kind of wrestling I do.
Hit me with a slight tube. I'm going to sell it. All right, go February week 1 Saturday. I've been liking the Saturdays.
Okay. Can live with the Saturdays.
What are we calling this?
Okay. Okay, so this is in February?
Yeah. Wasn't there another pay-per-view that we came up with from one of the old shows that was supposed to carry back over? It was the Swayze Invitational, which we got already, and there was supposed to be another one.
Oh, it was Gathering of the Juggalos.
We were going to steal... Yeah, but we don't have ICP this time, so we're not...
No, we don't.
What could our February show be? What can follow Iron Man Donkey Punch? That's hard, man. I don't know. I mean, what transitions from Iron Man, Donkey Punch in January that eventually leads up to the Swayze Invitational in May.
Well, you can always hit him with the Canadian Jackhammer.
The Canadian Jack, GDE Canadian Jackhammer?
Yeah, not available in Canada.
Not available in Canada? The GDE Ugandan Special? Live from Uganda?
Yes.
But we're there, we not go. In Uganda at all, it's just a green screen?
Yeah, GDE live from Uganda. Put it's, live in quotation marks.
It's just, it's a very noticeable green screen in the back.
Yeah. Yeah, so okay. We put live in quotation marks. Spell Uganda wrong.
How do you spell it?
It's U-G-A-N-D-A.
Wow. I really look like a moron than all the times I've been talking shit. You know how many times I've been in league and I was like, LCS Uganda.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Oh, man. That sucks. This is going to be a year. Now, you know what? I think this is just going to be a special this month.
It is.
I think next year we might come back with a different one. This is going to be a special.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's not going to be annual. It's going to be a special. The Live from Uganda special. Oh, shit. You know what, though? Props to us for... Even if we're not holding the show there, we're giving shout-outs.
Oh, we're absolutely giving shout-outs.
What are you irritated about? You got your fucking push. He's still irritated.
He's mad at his push.
That's from December, dude. He's still pissed.
Fuck. Buck up, fucko.
Oh, dude, didn't we have to get rid of Wife Beater?
Yeah. He's, he hasn't been beating his wife.
Look at all that. Excellent decision.
He just hates him.
Oh, that's funny. Ahmed was down with that.
Oh, hopefully it,
He just has morale issues now.
Hey, there...
Oh, shit. He's just annoyed now. That's awesome. Very happy at firing you made. What's Ahmed's problems with Wife Beater?
He hated that, dude.
What's up with that?
Straight up could not stand that,
like,
dude.
Like, damn. Maybe he was racist or something.
That's what I'm thinking.
He's like, fire that good old boy. Dude asked me to get him his coffee, and I'm not even a waiter.
I'm not even a fucking waiter.
El Dandy, do it. Ah, it's my fucking dream to just hire El Dandy, bro.
We need him.
He's got to be the world champion. I'm going to name him the American translation. It's just going to be The Dandy. Hollywood. I want to hire him, and then when he gets announced, it just has to be like that.
Yeah. Let's see if we can get him. Let's see if we can get him.
Like, the ring announcer is going to throw on a snapback and some shades and just be like, Hollywood!
160.
Let's do it.
Fuck it, yeah.
Oh, shit, Jay Lethal.
Oh.
190 in a peak. You know what? We really don't need any more low-level guys. Like, we need to get one more, not Jerry Flynn. Jimmy Yang. No. We need one more big name. Oh, shit, look, it's Chenna.
John Chenna.
Let's get Chenna. He's 260.
Sure.
Oh, WWE. Just stole your boy. He's not going to be John Chenna here, though.
No.
Oh, no. Let's, you know what? Let's skip to when we get Chenna.
No.
I want to change his name before we end this. This one's going to be good. All right. Who's getting booked weird? Him, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it keeps making him a road agent. I don't know why. Let's make him, I guess, an occasional wrestler.
No.
Yeah, we could do that. All right. What are we doing with Chenna over here? John Cena.
Well, his gimmick is a rapper.
Yeah, no, that's not going to fly.
No.
Well, maybe it's going to fly.
Okay. So...
He's a face.
No, he's gonna be a heel now.
Yeah, he's
Is gonna be the baby fucker.
We actually need faces though.
Yeah, that's true. Fuck. The baby lover.
We can make him ridiculous. Just something.
Yeah. Let's see what kind of gimmicks he can get here.
Let's see with
the woman beater.
It works on him too, but that's for heels. Someone who deals in domestic violence. Oh, man. Let's see what we got here. A slob? No. A simpleton? A sucker?
A sucker.
A redneck. Redneck Cena? Racist Cena. Oh, man. Why don't they have the Shockmaster gimmick?
Yeah, come on.
I've seen it be an oppressed minority. Oh, dude. The Mountie.
The Mountie.
This is a possibility. I'm going to come back to that. Seeing as a Mountie sounds hilarious. A lackey. A gypsy.
The gypsy.
A frustrated golfer. On heels. Damn, all the funny shit's for heels.
Ah, come on.
An Elvis impersonator? No. A DJ.
Country singer.
Dude, I'm just imagining a storyline where he makes someone go deaf with a hype horn.
Bam, 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 bam.
Bam, 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 bam.
DJ Cena's.
An adult film star. Hello, ladies.
Hello, ladies.
He's definitely not going to be a badass. A cartoon Joker. Yes.
No, you know what? He's a clubber.
So he's like our Fandango?
Yeah.
Okay. What's his name going to be? Because it can't be Cena.
No, it can't be Cena. Okay. It's got to be, like, the douchiest name
douchey. Like, so douchey that when you hear his name, you assume he wears Axe body spray.
Like, he wore a can of Axe body spray to the club.
Like, dude hasn't showered in a month. It's just Axe body spray.
Yeah. Uses it in his hair, too.
Wears beanies in the summer because it looks cool.
Mm-hmm.
Damn.
I'm going to Google douchey names quick. Most douchebag names. Okay, so the number one most douchebag name is Chad.
Chad?
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Yeah, okay.
If anyone watching this video ever comes across this and your name is Chad, you're a fucking douchebag. Let's just put that out there. You're a douche. You might be a nice guy, but your name just makes you a douche. Every time I hear Chad, it reminds me of Chad and Tad. Remember Fairly Odd Parents?
Oh, of course.
Bro, I remember, I think I was a teenager. I see that shit faded and I died laughing.
Okay. I got the douchiest thing I can come up with. Chad Rush.
Chad Rush?
Yeah. He's that dude.
That's pretty good.
He's that dude who is at the gym 24/7.
No, but it can't be. Rush is pretty good. But let's get something that makes him sound like a douchey club. Like, not the type of dude that goes to the club and, like, say, oh, I'm going to pick up chicks. Like, this dude is on the dance floor trying to, you know, yo, you got served. And it's not like, you know, new age, cool, breakdancing, three flips on your finger shit. Like, this is old school, crotch thrusting disco.
Okay. So we've established that the first name.
It's definitely Chad. Definitely Chad.
It's Chad, 100%.
This is hard, man.
It's always the last names that's the hardest.
Damn. I'm trying to think of just chode last names. Oh, this is easy. We totally missed this. Any dancing type or like just one of those types, they always have two first names. I don't know how that got past us. They always have, like, it's always like, you know, John Anthony or Jack Michaels. Chad Daniels. That's not douchey enough.
Chad Ryan,
yes. That is douchey as fuck.
Like, if I were to ever meet someone with the name Chad Ryan, I feel like I would punch them. Don't forget to change the biography from John Cena. Chad Ryan is a fucking douche.
Oh, hold on, you're gonna like this. Chad Ryan. Clubber. Dancer, douchebag. Come on.
I love it. Love it.
Alter ego, yes. 100% of the time. This nigga is Chad Ryan.
He lives this life.
Yeah, like, look at that face, son. He's mid-dance move right there.
He really is.
Like, dude just found out that he's in the finals. He's like, yeah! Okay. This is happening. You're asking why is he a face? Because people are going to like the fact that he's a douche. It's funny.
Exactly.
All right, we're gonna cut it here. You know, we got 25 days till the next show. When we come back, we'll show you the profit margin. We'll book the show. We're definitely going to do some funny shit with Chad Ryan.
Of course. He's going to be a big part of our company. Yeah, basically, we're going to make it, guys. We're all going to make it. I really have to go take a shit, though. So, Tony, you want to close this out?
Yeah, sure thing, guys. All right. So, next episode, we're going to push him. I think we're going to keep pushing Super Dragon, Blitzkrieg, you know, maybe do a face turn soon on someone. I'm not really sure who. I know that I'm going to try to get some more people over or maybe learn something from Ahmed because he's occasional. He's not going to be around for much longer. Basically, the main thing is I want to try to grow the company a little more, get some sign-ins before WWE starts stealing our people. So that's pretty much it. Catch you guys next time. Boy Tone Pepperone, Lieutenant Chubb. Catch you guys later.